The SpaceX officials expressed their understanding that the FAA is doing its best with the resources available to them, and they want to emphasize their unwavering support for the mission of ensuring safe spaceflight. Nevertheless, they believe that the FAA would greatly benefit from an increased workforce in its licensing department, and they encourage the agency to prioritize missions of national significance. In recent months, SpaceX has faced challenges as its programs have had to compete for reviews at the FAA. This has unfortunately resulted in a significant slowdown of the Starship program, and has put the development of a human landing system for NASA's Artemis program at risk. It is disheartening to see that inefficient regulation is impacting American competitiveness, especially as space programs in China and other countries continue to progress. In light of these concerns, SpaceX has organized a discussion ahead of a hearing before the U.S. Subcommittee on Space and Science. During this hearing, William Gerstenmaier, Vice President of Build and Flight Reliability at SpaceX, will be testifying. SpaceX is hopeful that Congress will provide guidance to the FAA on how to operate more efficiently. A SpaceX official expressed the hope that the committee can provide the FAA with a broader understanding of the goals they aim to achieve for the United States. Additionally, they suggested that the FAA could potentially be more innovative in interpreting certain rules and regulations. While safety is of utmost importance, perhaps there could be a greater emphasis on enabling spaceflight as well. It is clear that SpaceX is committed to ensuring safe spaceflight, while also striving for progress and innovation. They believe that with the right guidance and a more balanced approach, the FAA can better support the growth and competitiveness of the American space industry. SpaceX is making significant progress in the space industry, intending to launch approximately 90 rockets this year alone. However, the company is apprehensive about the potential obstacles that may arise. With the emergence of new players, such as United Launch Alliance's Vulcan rocket and Blue Origin's New Glenn, as well as increased flight rates by Virgin Galactic and Blue Origin's New Shepard suborbital tourism rocket, the FAA will have a lot on its plate. It is reasonable for SpaceX officials to be concerned about the FAA's ability to manage all of these activities simultaneously. They believe that the FAA should double the staff in the licensing division of its Office of Commercial Space Transportation and be granted accelerated hiring authority to attract the best candidates. The company also suggests that license applicants should have the option to contribute to funding independent third-party technical support to assist the FAA during the hiring process. It is evident that SpaceX is sympathetic to the challenges that the FAA will face and is proposing solutions to alleviate the burden. The regulatory process for space activities is complex and involves multiple agencies, including the FAA, NASA, and the U.S. Space Force. SpaceX's frustration with the backlog of work at the FAA highlights the challenges that companies face when trying to get approval for their projects. The delay in the review of Jalama Beach has forced SpaceX to divert resources away from other important activities, such as the analysis of Starship. This has caused their programs to compete with each other, which is not an ideal situation. SpaceX believes that the FAA should lean on other federal agencies for support, with the regulatory burden it faces. NASA and the U.S. Space Force have already signed off on the plans, so it's unfortunate that SpaceX had to divert resources away from reviewing Starship activity to get approval from the FAA. This highlights the need for a more streamlined regulatory process that takes into account the expertise of other agencies and avoids duplication of effort. In conclusion, the regulatory process for space activities is complex and can be frustrating for companies like SpaceX. The FAA should work with other federal agencies to streamline the process and avoid duplication of effort. We hope that the regulatory process can be improved in the future to support the growth of the space industry. SpaceX and its visionary leader, Elon Musk, have been instrumental in driving progress and innovation in the U.S. space industry. Their efforts to convince the U.S. Air Force to adopt an automated flight termination system, which has now become mandatory for U.S. rockets, is a testament to their commitment to safety and efficiency. As they continue to push the boundaries of space exploration, SpaceX officials are hopeful that the Federal Aviation Administration will follow suit and embrace a forward-thinking approach. While the FAA has been supportive of SpaceX's launch rate, there is room for improvement in terms of efficiency and flexibility. During his testimony, Gerstenmaier will appeal to Congress to prioritize programs of national interest, including the development of Starship, which is crucial to NASA's plans to land humans on the moon. It is important that the FAA recognizes the significance of these programs and provides accelerated review processes to ensure their success. We empathize with SpaceX's desire to establish a positive and productive relationship with the FAA, and we hope that the government will prioritize the needs of the space industry as we continue to explore the final frontier. We understand that the review processes for Starship are causing delays for SpaceX officials. It must be frustrating to have the rocket for the vehicle's second flight ready to go, but have to wait for at least 2 more weeks to complete regulatory review. We can imagine how concerning it must be for the company to think that similarly lengthy reviews will delay the future test flights needed to demonstrate Starship's viability, refueling capability, and ability to safely land on the moon. We empathize with the impact that these regulatory issues are having on the Artemis 3 mission to land on the moon. We hear that licensing for Starship is a critical path item for the Artemis program and for SpaceX's execution. We understand that operating the program at a higher cadence of flights is important for the success of the program, and that 6 to 8 month turns are not ideal. We hope that the regulatory review process can be expedited so that SpaceX can continue to make progress towards their goals. That's it for today's episode. We hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. Please let us know what you think in the comments section down below. Your feedback is very important to us, because it helps us make better videos for you. So thank you very much, and we hope to see you again next time.